minutes. But let me go across straight to Karan Bhagat, who's joining us right now. He's, of course, head of IIFL Wealth. Karan has been making an appearance roughly at the rate of once a month, starting from when the market was in the depths of despair to where we are right now. Karan, good morning. It's always a pleasure. Great to have you with us on CNBC TV 18.
Good morning. Good morning, Prashant.
I mean, Karan, one looks at the screen. It's just, you know, last couple of days, it's been a little slow, but otherwise, it's been a blowout move, hasn't it, Karan? What are your first thoughts at what we've seen so far?
Absolutely. I think, you know, we've been kind of surprised overall with the pace of the move over the last 2.5-3 months. Mm. But largely, it's been kind of global cues, which have kind of also played out in India. I think the recovery has been fairly sharp, especially on the headline indices and over the last 2 to 3 weeks over the broader market itself also. Having said that, I think the mood among clients continues to be a little cautious as far as equities go. I think we saw a little bit of profit booking around the 10,500, 10,700 levels, and clients still continue to be selective in terms of adding to long-term equity allocations. Having experienced the last 4 to 5 months, people are looking at a little bit more clarity and, most importantly, a sustainable recovery in demand before making sustainable, very large allocations to equity. On the flip side, however, there is a lot of kind of uneasiness on the low returns on the fixed income side. Money market funds have been at 2.5-3% over the last 4 to 5 months. AAA paper has been at 5-5.5. Invested for the short term, it's really earning post-tax returns of 2-2.5%. So that's not really too much of solace for the investor. And especially on the fixed income side, people want to explore more options and see how can they push the portfolio returns to 6-7% on a post-tax basis, as opposed to remaining at 2-2.5%.
Karan, you know, we've been also documenting, and I've put this data up and sort of we've discussed this in the past, the big jump in participation across the retail segment of the market, right? You say there is skepticism, people have been taken by surprise, I mean, you've been taken by surprise, your clients probably, I mean, actually everybody's been taken by surprise. Do you ascribe a large portion of this blowout move to the, you know, wide participation we've seen from the retail segment?
So I think part of it is obviously the sustained retail activity across the last 3.5-4 months. But Prashant, let's not forget, this is not uniquely what's happened in India. The retail participation's kind of increased across the globe. And I think that's also a little bit of a function of the kind of liquidity which has been in people's hands and the kind of low interest regime there has been. Also, the market's been a little trading oriented over the last 3 to 4 months. You've got a lot of volatility. You've got the opportunity to kind of enter. I think it's possible. I would ascribe liquidity as a much larger parameter to the uptick in the market as compared to just pure retail participation. I think globally, all central governments have kind of central banks have put in a lot of money, especially in the US, and at some point that money is going to flow and find its way into different markets. And I think that's what's really happened. From a high net worth and a retail investor perspective, obviously liquidity has been immense. You know, I've been in the business for the last 20 years. I've never seen clients sit on the amount of liquidity they currently sit on, especially on the fixed income side. On the equity side, I think the consensus trade has really been the top 30-40 stocks. And in the lack of better opportunities, a lot of investors are saying, you know, let's own these 30-40 stocks for the longer term. We'll definitely end up at a return much higher than 5-6% or 7%, what I'm going to get on fixed income. So I think as factor number one, I think I would still put liquidity right at the top. Second, I think lack of investment options, especially on the fixed income side, would be number two. And obviously, it's massively aided by the amount of retail participation, which has been seen in the markets over the last 2.5 to 3 months. From our perspective, I think we continue to be slightly underweight in equities post 10,500. I think out of a portfolio of 100 odd rupees, which has 55-60 rupees in fixed income, the remaining 45 rupees of equity we are potentially sitting around about 12 to 13 rupees in cash and invested 32, 33 rupees in equity. So we are ideally invested around about 70 to 75% of our equity allocation.
Karan, morning. This is Reema here. So if you could just throw some more light on this 32 to 33 rupees of equity out of a full portfolio of 100 rupees that you've invested in the market. What is the breakup looking like across sectors? You said it's concentrated in the top 30 to 40 stocks, but what is the preference now? And going ahead, is there any reason to believe, you know, is there any reason to change that allocation in equities considering mid caps have now started this up move and playing that catch up trade?
So I think over the last 3.5-4 months, I think the two sectors which have kind of got disproportionate allocation have obviously been a few consumer and FMCG oriented stocks, especially with a little bit of focus on a pan India kind of demand space as opposed to only the urban India space. And especially on the pharma side, it's been a decent trade over the last 3.5-4 months. The relative incremental disproportionate allocation to financial services relative to the benchmarks has been kind of pared down over the last 3.5-4 months. And I think we're pretty much more in line with the benchmarks in terms of financial services as opposed to having a disproportionate allocation. And I think overall, on the mid-cap side, we still continue to be on the large mid-caps as opposed to the small mid-caps. And I think from a portfolio construction perspective, typically less than 2 to 3% of our portfolio would really find its way into the second half of the mid caps. A larger portion would continue to be invested in the larger mid caps. So in that sense, I think still continue to be fairly heavy on consumer, a little bit of pharma. We have the right allocation to the benchmark heavyweights like Reliance and so on and so forth, and more or less equal to the benchmark in terms of financials as compared to, let's say, 12 months back, where we were disproportionately slightly higher in financials as compared to other sectors.
Okay, and this 30% of your equity portfolio, you're sitting on cash, right? At what point would you look to invest it? Would you wait for a Nifty to drop below 10,500? And is that something that's, your base case assumption right now that we will see a correction in the market and that's the time you would look to invest it? What would be the markers to, make that additional investment? And what about sectors like technology, which are expected to see this big benefit, be expected to be a big beneficiary of this whole outsourcing move?
Yeah, so our equity allocation, it's impossible to get the floor and the ceiling right every time. So from we follow an extremely tight scientific model based on both price to earnings as well as price to book. Obviously, I think the marker of 10,500 or 10,600 might change depending on how the to a certain extent how interest rates pan out, how the earnings recovery happens, and how does the kind of very little impact on global interest rates. But I think a combination of these three things put together will kind of dictate that level. I think putting earnings and the book value of the index today in perspective, I think we would wait for a correction around 10,600, 10,700. But let's not forget the model also kind of allowed us to put in a significant amount of allocation below the level of about 9,100, 9,200. So I think in that sense, we believe the relative risk reward currently of investing the remaining 30% into equities is something which is not that attractive. And we would like to have 25 to 30% in cash. And potentially over the next 3 to 6 months, we would have a better point to kind of make a bit of entry into the markets. So I think overall, on the tactical allocation perspective, I think we would continue to wait for a slightly better time. From a strategic allocation perspective on a conservative portfolio, I think the levels are still fine. We really don't need to make a big shift from equity to debt or debt to equity right now. But from a tactical allocation perspective, I think the risk reward to keep around about 25-30% in cash for our clients is fairly high, And therefore, we would like to kind of be at around about the 1/3 cash level right now.
Karan, your sense of the underlying sort of economy itself, I mean, you oversee this very large pile of cash for your clients, who themselves are could be business owners in many cases. What is the overall feedback that you're getting?
So I think the overall feedback at the margin has improved, Prashant and Rima, from the time we spoke last time. I think when I say it's improved at the margin, it means people don't feel that they're still hitting the ball out of the park. But the sentiment is definitely better where it was, let's say, when we met last time, 45 days back. I think broadly, business owners have the following kind of two big observations in that sense. I think consumer demands come back to a certain extent, but challenges remain. Supply bottlenecks have been much better compared to what they were a month and a half back. But at the same point in time, it's not something which is really kind of absolutely back to normal. People are kind of much more in the sense employees, people, business partners are much more in kind of recognition mode as far as COVID is concerned. People have kind of taken it as a part of their life and kind of moving on. So business activity is happening. And to that extent, I think consumer sentiment has improved tremendously. Having said that, do people still have enough confidence to go out and say that let's go out and invest in building new businesses and new capacity? I think that's going to take a little bit of a while. So I think definitely confidence has improved at the margin. The economy is doing better at the margin. Is it something which has kind of taken a full 360 degree turn, and business confidence as well as growth has kind of come back massively? I think the answer to that would need to be fairly cautious. But have things turned at the margin? The answer is definitely a yes.
Karan, a last question, and I request you to give a brief answer on this one. We've seen this big sort of move of money moving out of mutual funds over the last couple of months, whereas direct investing is rising. I mean, have you seen that across your client set as well?
No, that's true. I think it's a trend over the last 2 to 3 months, both on the equity as well as on the fixed income side. I think fixed income has also seen some challenges on the credit side of mutual funds over the last 2.5-3 months. The long-term capital gains on listed bonds is now fairly attractive at around about 14-15%. So a combination of those two things, plus I think the general inclination of concentrating a portfolio in the top 30 to 50 stocks has led to increased direct investing as compared to kind of mutual fund investing.
It's always a pleasure, Karan. Thank you very much for speaking with us here on CNBC TV 18. Thanks indeed. Karan Bhagat of IIFL Wealth saying that equity portfolio, they're still not up there in terms of full allocation, still, a little underweight once the Nifty crossed that 10,500, 10,600 mark. Expecting that they would get better opportunities 6 to 12 months down the line. As far as allocations are concerned, sort of overweight on consumer, okay as far as pharma is concerned, and a little equal weight actually on financial. So that's broadly the how the sectoral allocations lie for IIFL Wealth. We will take a very quick break here. First in the show, we are back.